I can show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, splinter groups within the autism world. We feel that by creating a narrative and putting a real face on this story of autism that is not a familiar story to many people, that is the best that we can do in this fight to get greater recognition, to get more states to, you know, to insist that insurance companies cover. You know, we work a lot with the Autism Speaks, you know, group and people to do what we can to have our story be the face of a real kid and a real family who have struggled to join with them in that political fight.
You know, Cornelia has often talked about the 22-year-old cliff, which I think you're referring to, is that once they hit 22, they're at the 21, meaning up to adult period, they just lose benefits. Everything just vanishes. And we're talking about now almost 4 million people in America on the autism spectrum. It's a crisis. We spend $126 billion a year serving this community. And, you know, we've been careful about not being too sort of politically engaged, because you make as many enemies as you win friends. But we pick our spots carefully. You know, when I'm doing a speech, Cornelia and I will talk ahead of time, like, what can you do on this one? Who's this group? How can you get through to them? So there was an example of this, is that after the book came out, I got a phone call saying, would you consider speaking in front of the General Assembly of the United Nations? I actually thought it was a buddy of mine, like, doing a prank. You know, but I realized it wasn't after a minute. And I'm like, sure. So on April 2nd, the day after the book came out, I spoke to the General Assembly of the UN. I know, quite a crazy thing going on here. And it was interesting because, you know, I don't know if any of you have been much to the United Nations. It's, you know, it's kind of hard to get a pulse going there. All that cement, the kind of high ideals, not much realized. So I'm there in this giant room. I mean, it's an airplane hangar, you know, and I'm doing my speech and I'm trying to get something going. You know, and they're all sitting here, you know, the guy from Burundi, you know, with the fear fog. And I saw across the room, there were a bunch of kids in blue shirts, because it was lighted up blue. It was World Autism Awareness Day.
Right.
And so I'm trying to say, how do I finish this speech? And all of a sudden, I see them over there, they're looking kind of intently. I mean, I'm telling them about Disney Club, this group that Owen now is the center of. And all of a sudden, it dawns on me. There's a theme song, an anthem of Disney Club at Owen's school. And it's a particular song, it's the Belle song from Beauty and the Beast. And so I take the mic off the stand and I walk across this giant well at the UN, this group of kids. And I'm in tight, I'm like, it's about two dozen. I'm like, okay, you know the Belle song. And they're all, you know, like junior high school stuff. And you know the end of the Belle song? I said, just the last three verses. And they immediately get it. So you got the whole UN there, and I go, okay, let's go. And they all sing, I'm sure you guys know it, I want adventure in the great wide somewhere. I want it more than I can tell. And for once it might be grand to have someone understand. I want so much more than they've got planned. And they sang it to the United Nations.
Oh, wow.
A challenge. That's the way you do it.
So, as a journalist, Ron, I have admired your work for an awfully long time, your ability to get to the heart of some of the most important stories of our day, having read Life Animated and having met your family. I admire you even more now for the way you've raised your two sons. Thank you so much for your
Thank you very much. Thank you. Please sit. Thank you, Ron, Walter, and Cornelia. Thank you, Rick, as well. My name is Issa Joseph, and I have the privilege of co-chairing the 27th Annual Jewish Book Festival. I was mentored by Lori Suskind last year, and I hope I'm doing a good job. This was an absolutely wonderful event, and thank you so much. We would now like to call Jonathan Richard up to the stage. He will be accompanied by his mother as he sings a song.
Suskind family wants a huggy. Wow. My, wow. We are kindred. I, oh my God. That was amazing. Wow. Wow.
That was quite outstanding. Thank you so much, Jonathan and Evelyn. Lovely. Thank you. This night would not have been as successful as it is if it were not for our community partner, Jeff Poe, and Sarah Frankel, who is the executive director. And on behalf of Jeff Poe, we would like now to call to the stage Craig Ponhauser, who is a past president of the J, as well as an active board member of the Children's Ability Center. He will give us a presentation on behalf of Jeff. Please welcome him.
I don't know how to check this.
Wow, that is a hard act to follow. That's all I have to say. Well, Ron, Cornelia, Walter, you guys, you're amazing. You're unbelievable. We thank you for sharing all of your personal, yes, big round of applause. Wow. So your personal and heartfelt